All right, so here we are, Soulection Radio. My name is Joe K. Wherever you are in the world, this is a very special one. We got the legend. I don't even really have to introduce the man. This is just very important, just not to the Soulection culture, but to you, whether you realize it or not, because this man is responsible for not only writing hits, but making timeless music, music that is still affecting the culture today. Even if the young generation is still, you know, they could go somewhere and they hear it and they may not even know that it's this man in front of me. But at the end of the day, this music is still being played and the longevity of it. I got Ginuwine in the building.
Yeah. What's up, Doc?
What's up, brother?
Ain't nothing, man. I want to first thank you and Soulection and everybody that supported us, man, for the last 20 years. You know, I've been in the business 20 years, man. We're going to get right into it, Joe.
Damn,
yo,
bro.
Man, thank you, man, for having me, man. And I'm open, man. I want you to ask me whatever because I want to educate.
Yes.
I want to educate, dude.
Yes, and that's
you,
why we're here.
Everybody listening?
Please.
Let's go.
Yo, I got, yeah, you ready for this?
Yeah, absolutely,
Are
man.
You ready?
Absolutely.
All right, dog. Another one.
Yeah. But yeah, you know how we do, dog.
So let me actually just give the people a little background real
let's
quick, because I think it's important for people to know how we connected
absolutely.
About close to 3 years ago. Yep. I want to say 2.5. So our guy, Monty, who's family related to you.
Yep.
So the whole moral of this story, what I'm about to get into, is really comes down to you never know who's watching.
Absolutely.
Right? So we were just going about our thing about 2.5 years deep into Soulection. We weren't that old. And we were just putting out music, and Monty found us. And one day he tweets us, right? And he's like, yo, right now I am showing my uncle Ginuwine. I'm putting him up on game with Soulection.
Yep.
And I didn't believe. I was like, yeah, someone could have just said it. Yeah. So when I got back to him and DM'd him, and then all of a sudden you said you responded on Twitter.
Yeah.
And that was the start of it. And then fast forward 2 weeks later, we had just got back from Coachella, because we curated some artists and some stages back in the campgrounds.
Yeah.
And that was legendary. And that was honestly the start of our progression.
Absolutely.
And to this very point here at Beats One.
Yep.
And you guys invited us to the studio.
Absolutely.
And when we went to the studio, man, one, you were recording the TGT.
Yeah.
Remember? Shout out to Tank, Tyrese.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That was a special time in itself. We'll get into that. But I was wearing sandals, right? I was wearing, and you guys clowned me.
Not me, baby. Hey, listen.
I got roasted.
Listen, I know the comfort of a person, you know, if that's what you're comfortable in, who am I to say anything?
I'm all ready.
But you know what I'm saying? Like, honestly, man, listen, like, Beats One, we here, man.
Yeah.
I thank y'all so much, Soulection, for having me here. You know what I mean?
Course.
Because we go back a little while, man, and I'm telling you, when you came to the studio, man, I knew that was some sort of magic. Honestly.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly. This is you and I talking.
I appreciate that.
When you start to play the songs, you gotta remember when you played the songs, everybody from out in the hallway started to come in. You
That's
remember?
Real.
And I was like, oh, he's got something.
He got the juice.
Yeah, absolutely. So, man, I was like, look, my nephew was like, Unc, I'm telling you, listen to him. And I'm, you know, I'm always one track minded.
I know.
But he opened my mind, man. He was like, listen, times is changing. Music is changing. You know what I mean? So you got to change with the times. And when he did that, I was like, all right. And, you know, we had our little, you know, our little thing in the beginning, you know, things didn't work out the way that I thought that
it's
it should
good.
Work out.
We still here, though.
It's still
we
family.
Are here.
It's still the way
always.
That it should be, man. And I thank y'all so much for supporting and always wanting to see me win. Because that's one thing I respect about you, respect about my nephew and everybody that's in the Soulection family, man. Y'all always wanted to see me win. You know what I mean? And then me as an old school cat, you know what I mean? I ain't that old. Don't get it twisted now. But me used to doing things in the, you know, in the old-fashioned way,
yep.
I kind of let things slip by. But now, because you guys have constantly stayed on me and constantly drilled me, yo, Unc, it's like this. I ain't even your uncle. You still saying, yo, Unc, it's like this. It's like that. And I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna digress. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to lay back. I'm gonna listen.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Because things has changed.
That's important.
Yeah, because like if you're in a room and you're smarter than everybody in the room, you need to get out of that room. You understand what I'm
That's
saying?
Real.
You always got to be in a room with people that you can learn from.
That's real.
And even it doesn't matter about the whether you are younger or whether you are older. It's about who it is and what they're doing. And you guys, whether you're younger or not, man, I can learn from y'all.
That's right.
I'm learning from y'all right now. I gotta digress, man. I can't be that much prideful just because I sold this or I done that. That don't mean nothing. It means something in the realm of history, but it doesn't mean anything in the realm of right now.
Okay.
And that's why I listen now. I listen to y'all, and y'all got me here, man. And I think there's nothing more
important.
Powerful.
Yeah. I got to stop you right there and just highlight the fact that you said someone that being is an OG in the game and a veteran and very wise and that has done a lot, seen a lot, even in an era that's not equivalent to what it is today.
Right.
They didn't have cell
totally
phones.
Different.
They didn't have the social media. So it was kind of, even in my opinion, a lot harder back then.
Absolutely,
you had to do a lot.
Dude.
But so you coming from that time, that's respect. And that's why going back to our connection when we first started, is, you know, I don't really, I've always kind of been around great people all my life as a young child, but that was the first time I actually felt nervous being in that studio because the first thing that comes in my mind is this man has been
history.
Making hits in Timbo.
Yeah.
I think about Aaliyah.
Yeah.
I think about Missy. I think about Static Major.
Yes.
I think about Jodeci.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
And just to, like, damn, I'm playing tracks from our camp, from guys in their bedroom as we speak making
Absolutely.
Music. And to see Tyrese run in the room, to see Tank run in the room, to see, I forgot the owner of the studio.
Big Dog.
To see everyone come in and start asking questions, like, who's that? And you know, that was a moment in my life where I realized, like, yo, we got something special here.
I'm sorry.
The underdogs, all good.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you remember, but we had some of our finest, Esta and Mr. Carmack.
Absolutely.
And you quote-unquote said that Carmack was someone that
special, that
reminded you of Timbaland.
Yes.
And that is powerful within itself. But
Absolutely.
We'll get into that later. We talked about earlier that I would love to actually just kind of have like a music session with you. I don't know if you really ready real quick.
Oh man, I'm always
but we're
ready.
About to take
I'm
it back.
Ready, Neff.
I'm just
I'm ready
all right, Unc. We're about to just play something and let this ride out and just kind of see what was your mindset this time. Let's get into it.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Yeah. Wow. Let me tell you something, man. That brought me back way back to 93. Dude.
Wow.
Yeah.
I was only 4 years old at the time.
Man, that was in D.C. and I forgot the name of the studio. Forgive me.
That was off the basement demo tape.
Yeah, that was in D.C., dude.
I don't even know how. You can tell it has like a tape hiss. It's the quality ain't great at all.
God, where did you get that, bro?
I don't know, man. The internet, bro.
I almost didn't remember it. And I had to listen. And I was like, help me. But, oh, man, you know what, though? Back in the days when we was doing that, man, that was when we was trying to form it, you know, trying to form the basement. You know, the basement wasn't the basement until like about 95.
Who was part of the basement? 94.
Part of the basement was Boogeyman, Magoo, Timbaland, Tweet,
Missy,
of course myself.
Are you guys all from the DMV?
No. Missy, Timbaland, and all of them are from Virginia. Static Major, rest in peace. I love him so much.
I want to talk about him later.
Louisville. Let me say it right the way he taught me to say it. Louisville. Kentucky.
Who's from Louisville? Who's from there?
That was Black, Static, and you know, Player.
Okay, Player.
Player
was, that
was
his group.
Yeah, that was his group, dude. And he did a lot of the writing. But all of them, like, one thing I gotta say about them, man, that they were way ahead of their time, dude. Honestly, I'm telling you. Like, people really don't
understand.
Like, I'm telling you, they were way ahead of their time.
Well, why and how?
Because Static was a jewel. You know what I'm saying? Like, when y'all heard...
Can you tell people just in a very, like, quick summary the songs that he co-wrote, that he wrote? We'll start off with Pony.
Yeah, it's so many.
Yeah.
Like, most of Aaliyah's hits in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Myself with Pony, same OG, So Anxious. All of his Player stuff. You know, he was one. He did Lollipop
for Lil Wayne.
Yeah. So he was very ahead of his time, dude. You know what I mean? And he was really a jewel that was really being held back a little bit. And we won't get into that. But you know, he was one of those jewels, man. And he was he was delivered to the Lord way before his time, yeah, man. Like,
that's a tragedy.
That dude, I'm telling you, man, like, that dude was a jewel. Like, Static Major, man. If it wasn't for him, honestly, let me tell you a little story. When Timbaland played Pony, of course, the lyrics wasn't made, of course, right? Me and Static was in the room, right? Mm-hmm. And he told me that he was using it for some bodyguards for interlude.
Oh, wow.
Nobody said nothing. Not even Static. Love him to death. That's my man. I said, Tim, can I please have that? Are you crazy? he was like, what are you talking about? You like that? Tim, look at me in the camera. Timbaland didn't even hear that. You know what I'm saying? That's my man. Love him to death. Nah. But honestly, he was like, you like that? I said, I love it. Please don't use that as an interlude, dude. He was like, all right, because Timbaland was the man, still is the man.
He made so much heat that it was just like another
thing. He was like, whatever.
But you recognize that.
I swear, we was just talking.
You know, can I say something, actually?
Yes,
I've always admired your ear.
Yes.
Your beat selection is crazy.
Listen, I was just telling my nephew, Chris, we was talking about movies and stuff. Since now I'm in acting class, I'm trying to get into movies and everything, uh-huh, right? But I was just telling him, like, I see things before it actually has been done.
Wow.
You understand
what
I'm saying?
That's a gift.
That's a gift.
Uh-huh.
Like, he might not like it, but I see it. You know what I'm saying? So I saw what Pony could be. And I was like, please give me that. So he said, all right, you can have it. I'll make another. I said, thank you. So me and Static went downstairs. Static was like, gee, give me a little minute. Just let me do the hook. And I respected his ear because he was writing rhymes. He was doing a whole bunch of stuff, right? So I went upstairs, right? So he hit me. He's like, come on down. Come on back down, right? So I come down. If you're on there, let's. I said, oh, my God. Oh, my God. What? And then I said, I have to be a part of this, Static. I have to be a part of this. I said, I'll give you 40%. I need this 10%.
That's real.
So now I said, I need to help you write the verses. I said, let's go line for line. Let's battle. Because in the basement, that's all we used to do is battle. Me, DeVonte, Timbaland,
like
Missy.
Like battle rap?
No.
Like just like lines, like come up with the best
songs,
verses. Yeah,
with
yeah.
songs,
oh,
right?
Wow.
All, Missy, Timbaland, me, DeVonte, Timbaland.
Is there any footage about like?
I don't know. It probably is. Well, the cell phones wasn't prevalent as
yeah,
it is now.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I said, I'm just a bachelor. And he said, looking for a partner.
Wow.
And I said, son, wow. We
you know
killed
what?
That.
Hold up.
I'm telling you.
Can we get into Pony?
Yes,
we
sir.
Get into Pony
let's
right
do
now.
It.
We got to.
Yes, let's do it. Yeah.
But I mean, I couldn't, while this music was playing, I couldn't just stop thinking about what you said about how you guys would battle each other. And
absolutely.
That's, I've never heard of singer of vocalists and writers battling each other to see who has the best line and the best melodies, the best hooks. And is that something that you feel still goes on today?
Let me tell you something. Like, I think that's what's missing, dog. You know what I mean? Like, when you have crews, I think you need to get everyone in the room because you want the best product. You feel what I'm saying? So what we used to do is gather in the studio, right? Timbaland. Just think of it. Everybody, listen. I want you to envision this, right? You don't know Timbaland and everybody else, Ginuwine. You don't know everybody, right? Uh-huh. Just envision every one of them hungry as hell, right? They're giving their best. You got Missy, one of the best ever to me. I love her to death. That's my sister. Talked to her 2 days ago. You know what I'm saying? Timbaland, one of the best producers ever in the world. I don't care about nobody else, and I'm not disrespecting nobody.
No, that's real.
You know what I'm saying? I think Timbaland is one of the best producers ever. Do you understand
that's
what
real.
I'm saying?
Yeah.
DeVonte, one of the best R&B producers ever to me. You know what I'm saying? Then you got Tweet. Then you got myself. Then you got Boogeyman. You got Magoo. You got the undeniable Static. You know what I'm saying? So just imagine everybody in the room, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then you got, it's just us, because we kick everybody out, right? So we're trying to make a song, or we're battling each other. You know what I mean? So the person that comes up with the best line, they win. And the decider, of course, is DeVonte. He's the head man. He's the dog.
Okay.
He's the,
so it wasn't Timbaland deciding?
No. It wasn't Timbaland. It was DeVonte. But the one thing I got to say about DeVonte is that if you did come up with a line that was dope, he wouldn't hate. He was like, ooh, no, that was dope.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that's what we would do.
Yeah.
Now, you know, if you don't have crews like that, I mean, if you're doing everything by yourself, that's cool too. But it's nothing like battling. It's nothing like battling. It's like battle rap.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's nothing like battling. Like, I can come up with a better line than you.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
And that kept the competition and the lines the best. I have a question.
Yeah.
Now, if there was some, if something was whack, would you guys tell each other straight
up? Absolutely.
Like, I'm not feeling it.
Absolutely.
Okay, that's important.
You know what it is? Like, when you're young and when you're doing all of that, you look to the head. The head was DeVonte. You know what I mean? And then you can only base things by him. You know what I mean? Because he was the man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So if he said it was whack, it was whack.
Yeah.
If it was dope, it was dope.
Yeah.
So I trusted, and I think everyone else trusted, that when he said it was dope, it was dope. Yeah. I think it was fair.
It was fair.
You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
But, you know, at times, of course, you know, if he's doing something, you know, he want to get his stuff in there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But now, honestly, I just think he was being fair. But he's a lyrical, musical genius. I put him up there with Prince. I really do.
Wow. And I know MJ's.
I put DeVonte up there with Prince.
Wow.
Absolutely.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And
is there something that we can get into from DeVonte that like, when you think about DeVonte's name, what's a record that comes to mind?
Freaking you.
We will get into.
Can I say something?
Okay.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
We were in Rochester, New York, right?
Uh-huh.
This is a story. We were in Rochester, New York, right? DeVonte told me, because I was his cousin. You know, he said everybody, you know, we looked alike and all that kind of stuff, right? So he was like, that was because he would talk to Timbaland and he would talk to me, right?
Mm-hmm.
He said, I'm going in this room for a week. Look at me in my eyes. A week.
Wow.
And it wasn't a lie. I'm going to create a song that's going to put Jodeci, this second, it was the after party, whatever it was.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna create a song. It wasn't Diary of a Mad Band, was it?
I'm not sure.
No, it was the after party of hotel, right? He was like, I'm going to create a song that's going to be the signature of this record, right?
Yeah.
I don't even know when he ate. I'm serious, dude. Like, he was in that room. We would come, like, we went up to Rochester, New York, right? And there was a 3-level studio. He got the bottom studio. Me, Timbaland, Missy, and him was only on the bottom, right? Then there was another level, and there was another level. And every time I would come in, I would knock on the door. It would be music going on. He would not answer the door, man.
Yeah.
He would not answer the door. And that was like my cousin. I love that dude.
I was like,
can I be a part of it? Can I get it?
And how old were you at the time?
Oh, man, I don't know. Like
early
23.
20,
yeah.
Yeah. You and just want to like, be a part of
yeah,
it.
Yeah, and he would not answer the door.
Okay, because he was so, that serious.
I'm always going to give props to those, regardless of what happened.
That's like some Kobe work ethic.
Listen,
right there.
Regardless of what happened, Like that's another movie.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Of course.
But regardless of what happened, that dude is a genius.
He's a genius.
You understand what I'm saying?
So tell the people what record we're going to get into right now.
Dude.
What's that record that you want to get when you think about his name? When you think about DeVonte?
Freaking you.
Let's
is
get into that.
You?
Yeah.
Listen to this song right here. This is weeks. Actually, a week and a half.
Mm-hmm.
A week and a half where he would not answer the door. Like, if he got his food, it was like you was in 23 lockdown, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they would slip his food up under the door, right?
Yeah.
He would not answer the door. I couldn't get in. This is the record that he created.
All right. Freaking you. We're about to get in here on Beats One with Ginuwine.
Let's do it.
This is straight. This is an educational. This is a great
Absolutely.
Process right now. I love it.
All Selection.
Right? Yes. Keep it locked. Yeah, and that Drake Yo. Actually sampled that as well. Look What You've Done, and that was a
perfection.
Yeah, when I really heard that, man, that's a timeless. And I don't know when that was even written or when that was recorded, but when I watched that, man, that just made me gave me chills.
You're about to make me cry, man. What are you doing, man? You're doing too much history, dude. Man, I missed that dude so much, man. I remember him calling me, and he was like, "Gee, we got to get you back where you need to be, man."
How long, when was this? What year?
Man, it was like right after my mom died.
Oh, man.
You know what I mean?
Rest in peace, moms.
Yeah, man, he was like, "Man, I got to get you back." And then, you know, I did Differences.
Uh-huh.
I did a lot of other joints.
Another hit?
Yeah. Yep. And then he was like, he said, "Gee, you don't need me no more." I said, "Yes, I do. If you give me 30 chances, of course I'm going to come up with one."
Yeah.
But you get 5 chances and you're going to come up with one. Yo, man, come on. We're playing the lottery. Let's do it.
So
let's do it.
What's it like watching the youth embrace you, take the music that you and the Basement Crew created, but specifically you, what's it like hearing your music sampled and used today? I'm talking about when you think about all these producers in the bedroom, when you think about even, you know, we talked about Drake earlier on the mixtape, you know, on Legend, he sampled So Anxious and even Thank
Shout
You.
Shout out to him, man.
Yeah, OVO,
shout out to that dude, man.
40, they show you a lot of love. And even at the end of the credits, you know.
He gave my name last.
And that after
actually
Madonna.
Means something.
Yeah.
That actually, listen. Like, come on, man.
What does that feel like?
Like, come on, I got to stop you, my dog. Come on, listen. For that dude to be number one right now and doing what he's doing right now and transitioning music and doing what he is doing, man, for me to be last is not last, actually.
Yeah.
Because you remember last.
Yep.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yep.
And for him to put me last, I felt like, wow, dude, you really respect what I've done, and I appreciate you noticing what I've done. You know what I mean? I'm nine CDs deep. You know what I feel me? So for him to do that, man, I gotta respect that man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he's so talented, man. He's one of the best that's out today, if not the best.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me?
Yeah.
So gotta give a shout out to Drake.
What's
for that,
your take on these new development of artists who are rappers but are also like Drake, like the way he sings, and like even if you think about Hotline Bling, he's not even rapping, but it's like a melodic vibe. Yeah. What's your take on that?
Let me tell you something, man. Like me, I've always been simple. Like, I'm not a runner.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? And for that dude to acknowledge that, you know, what I've done for music and sample whatever it is that I've done, and you know, to do what he did, man, I just gotta shout him out for that. You know what I mean? Because a lot of times you get caught up in, you know, people running and doing all kind of gymnastics that you can't do.
Yeah.
And you be like, okay, I'm not that good. You understand what I'm saying? But I've learned not only from him, but just learned from past dealings that everyone can't run, you know what I'm saying? But when you do things that people can do and sounds good and it's simple.
And relatable.
And exactly, the operative word. Thank you. Relatable, man. That's what resonates. That's what people grasp a hold of. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people can't run. Only people can run is when they're in the bathtub in that square area and they're, and it sounds like they're doing it,
yeah,
but they can't. So simplicity, that's what's vital in this business right now.
It really is.
You understand what I'm saying?
Well, simplicity, you said something, you raised a really important point earlier about an artist nowadays who are searching for just the hit.
Yeah.
You're a guy of timeless music. You're like, again, your music is still being played today.
Absolutely.
In all areas. It's very important.
Yep.
And to an artist coming, even to successful artists in the mainstream, what's your words of wisdom for longevity? and how do you make timeless
can
music?
Can I preach?
Yeah.
Can I preach?
Please do.
Can I preach? Listen, hey, my little nephew, he's in acting class right now. He thinking he know everything. He doing anything. But I'm constantly telling him, man, like,
shout out Chris.
My little nephew, Chris. You know what I'm saying? Simplicity, dog. You can't overthink stuff. when you get in that studio, man, you got to sing what you feel. Mm-hmm. You got to rap what you feel. You can't overthink nothing. You can't say the right word. Yeah. Why? Because a lot of the words that you're trying to look in the dictionary for, they don't know. You know what I'm saying? You got to relate to them. You got to say the words that they know. Hear and know. You understand what I'm saying? And that's what makes hits, man.
What about transparency?
Well, you always got to be, listen. You always got to be open. Listen, I'm about to do a reality show, right? And I know people like, everybody's doing a reality show. But I ain't throwing drinks on you. I'm not cursing. I'm not doing all that. Guess what I'm doing? I'm doing a show sort of like T.I. You know what I mean? Shout out to T.I., man. I was trying to do one of those shows for a long time, and I told them that there's an audience for that. But, you know, everybody wants the drama. Everybody. No one wants the education. Some people want the drama. No one wants the education. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of times, regardless of what you think, take the biggest thug in the world, right? When he's young. What happens when he gets old? He looks back and say what? Ah, I shouldn't have did that. So time, wisdom comes within in time. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm saying? So if I'm doing a show and I'm giving you that time, now I ain't 20-something. I'm where I am. But I'm educating you on where you should be right there. Mm-hmm. What's the old saying? If I knew then what I know now, I wouldn't be here. Mm-hmm. Right?
Yep.
So if I'm trying to educate you on that, listen to me. I've been everywhere. I had the women. I'm divorced now. I done everything. You know what I'm saying? Listen to me. I ain't God. But with age comes wisdom. You don't know what I know if you're 20. You don't know that.
Yeah.
Period. You know what I'm saying? There's no way you know what I know if you're 20. You know what I'm saying? Listen to me. And that's what's... Listen, look what is happening to the world right now, man. We got people coming over here and people that's already here, planted, all kind of stuff. Things is happening.
Yep.
Open your eyes, man. Just like Spike Lee did it in that joint, he said, wake up with Samuel Jackson, dog. Wake up. Wake up. You don't know everything at 20.
Yeah.
You don't know everything at 25.
Yeah.
You gotta look to
be a sponge, be open-minded.
Yeah. You gotta absorb all of the stuff that's coming in from you, from others that's older and that experienced everything that you're trying to experience, man. Yeah. Because you don't know everything. And then that's the problem right now with the younger cats, man. They think they know everything, man. And you don't.
Yeah.
You don't. Look at anybody. You know what I'm saying? Like the thugs that everybody was like, oh, he's hard. He's this. Catch him about 10, 15 years from now.
Where are they now?
Yeah. He'd be like, oh, man, you shouldn't do that. Because with age comes wisdom. If you're that stupid and you don't want to listen, you're going to end up in jail, dead. You know what I'm saying? Or in a lot of trouble, man. You can't do that. So that's all I'm trying to do on the R&B front, man. And just educate.
So R&B music today, in your opinion, is missing
education, man.
Okay. So different. And that's one of my favorite albums, 100% Ginuwine.
Really?
Yeah. That's like, I don't know, the the production on there, bro, was just so.
That's Timbaland.
So crisp. I mean, you guys are like the Kobe and Shaq, you know?
I appreciate dude.
In my opinion.
I appreciate
There's like a lot of different great duos in the game.
Absolutely.
All across the board and all genres of music. But your guys' duo was impeccable.
I appreciate that.
Like
man.
You said, your team that you guys have built. It's just something, man, today that. I don't know if it'll ever, you know, it's the same thing when you hear, you know, LeBron and Kobe speak about Michael Jordan.
Yes.
When you hear Pippen. People.
Michael Jordan and Pippen.
When you hear people just in general speak about Michael Jackson and things like that. You know, there's just certain things that people will never be able to replicate because it just doesn't get any greater than that.
I think what it is, man, is that once you hear that magical moment and that new musical perspective of whatever, you know, you remember that, and that, you know, that sticks in your mind. You know what I mean? I think Timbaland can do music with anybody that he wants to do music with, and this is not no, you know, reach out to him, but I'm serious. I just always believe that there will never be a connection like him and Missy, him and myself, him and Magoo.
Of course.
I mean, you can be successful, but will those songs play forever?
Yeah.
And that's what, just like Dre, he can do Eminem, and Eminem is one of the best vocalists ever. Mm-hmm. But guess what? You want to hear him and Snoop.
Yep. You were just talking about that earlier.
Here and Snoop. That's what I'm listening to now going into Same OG 2016. You know what I'm saying? That's the name of the new CD that I'm working on.
Okay,
right,
let's talk about that. Yeah. And what is the direction that you're trying to go with this new music of yours?
You know what? Right now, I'm looking to deal with you guys, okay. Soulection.
You guys just heard it here. Yeah. I'm going to hold you to
absolutely.
That this time.
Come on, man. Stop it. You're just saying that. Just
nah,
saying
I'm
that.
Serious.
Yes. So listen.
See, I didn't have a recording to play that back
you.
At you.
Let me educate you on that. You know what I'm saying? But because I understand y'all, you guys work ethic, you understand history of music. You ain't trying to get me to, I won't even say no names.
Yeah.
You're not trying to get me to do what's going on right now.
Yeah.
You're trying to reestablish what has happened for me in the history of music. And those people are not old. They right here. They ain't gone nowhere.
Yeah.
So we can still reestablish what we created back in the day. You know what I'm saying? And that's what you guys are trying to do. So that's what I'm trying to do again. Listen, if 18-year-olds, 19-year-olds, 21-year-olds still want to deal with it and all that, you know, and enjoy the music that we are creating, so be it. I love it. I embrace it. I welcome it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, I'm trying to cater to who I came up with.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? And you guys, as brilliant and as talented as you guys are,
appreciate
y'all
that.
Understand that. That's why you here
yeah.
in this studio. They got all kind of electronics going on. You understand? Because you guys' genre and y'all and what y'all doing, it's now. It's today.
Nah.
You understand what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, y'all don't push aside what has already happened.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? So people that supported me from 20-year-olds or whatever to now or whatever, they're still here.
Mm-hmm.
They're not. That's why I love Uncle Charlie, Frankie Beverly, all those guys are still selling out arenas. Now, you guys may not know that because y'all not there. Man, I still do shows with them and they're selling out football stadiums.
That's crazy.
Why? Because their people are still here. So y'all will be saying what I'm saying 20, 30
years
from now. And because y'all people are still here.
Yep.
Only difference is that I still attract or I still, you know, cater to, you know, what's going on right now. Thankfully, I'm not an old gray head man and all that kind of stuff. And I still jump on every speaker. I still break dance. I still do everything that I do. But that's love. You know what I'm saying?
You really raised some important points. Just about embracing the culture.
Absolutely.
And something that's kind of been the theme of this conversation this whole time. But, you know, you're talking about this room with technology.
Yeah.
Is it tough for you, you know, because you guys didn't have this, you know, 15 years ago. And, you know, you could upload an idea. Someone could share what's going on in the studio and you didn't, you know.
Right now.
So is it hard for you was it hard for you in the beginning when everything started progressing? Like
operative word, beginning. Yeah, I was, and shout out to Monty. That's my little nephew. Love him to death. He made me embrace what's happening right now.
That's
because
real.
I was really in tune, on point, whatever, with what's going on back in the day. And sometimes you got to shake somebody and be like, look, it's a different time. So you got to get with what the time is. And now that's why I'm on this radio show. People that's listening don't even understand why I'm here. They understand it. Like, it's a lot of things that's about to go on. It's about to like. You can't help but to like it. Why? Because it's a familiar voice. And it's going to be a familiar sound.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And it's about to happen. So I want to thank you, Soulection, you know what I'm saying, Beats One, and everybody that's listening right now, because now is the time to make the change, man. You know what I mean? Now is the time to make the change.
That's real.
Not only to make the change, time to make the connection. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people understands, like, you know, when you listen into the radio and you hear a voice that's familiar, you be like, oh, that's dope. And that's why Drake, Nicki Minaj and all those people are sampling our voices, because the familiar mm-hmm. is good to hear.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? So now when you put on Ginuwine, whether it be Pony, whatever, the familiar is good to hear. Whether you was a kid or not, you remember that. So you can cut out my verses and he's rapping or doing whatever else, but the familiar sound is great.
You already know where it comes from.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's what we're doing right now. And that's what I think people will love and appreciate about me. I'm open. You know, like I said, I'm doing a reality series right now, and the reality series that I'm doing right now is about me winning. I'm not throwing drinks on you. I'm not doing anything. It's sort of like a game show. You know how you do what's the ninja thing or whatever that you do? The ninja thing when they do obstacle courses and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So you want them to win. Now I'm that guy that you're going to root for to win, because you remember what I've done.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's important for
people.
That's so important for people. You know what I mean? So yeah, that's what it's about, man. And I'm telling you, Soulection, Beast One, that's what we're going to do, man.
That's a trip to hear what people today can do with vocals and just an idea. Like, that's incredible, man. And what's cool about this stuff is, without you having to even be present in these festivals and these shows, songs like that and vocals like you were talking about are spreading the world. And you're whether you realize it or not, your sound is still relevant all over. And you don't, you're at home. You're watching the Dallas Cowboys game.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I see it.
Yeah.
Hey, let me tell you something though. When we did that joint right there,
mm-hmm.
that was the first introduction for me to technology.
Wow.
Me and Nas wasn't in the studio together.
Oh wow.
I was in L.A. He was in New York.
Wow.
But he was talking to me.
What year was that, you think?
Man.
Like 97, 98?
97, yeah. Something like that.
That was such an important time.
That was
Y2K, remember that? DMX, Nas, Jay-Z.
That's why this is what you're doing right now, dog, is so important.
Time capsule.
Like, this is like a transition of time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I was, like, when I walked in the studio, I heard Nas. He was in New York. And I was like, what the fuck? If we're not on the phone, like what?
Yeah.
And he's in the studio loud. Mm-hmm. Yo, G, that was dope. Do it like this. Yo, sing this way and da 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 da.
On the phone, you said?
No, he was in the studio.
Oh, in the studio. Okay.
This technology.
Yeah.
Like, this was the first time that, you know, a lot of people, you had to be in the same studio with everybody.
Yeah.
You understand? Mm-hmm. So when I went, I was here.
Okay.
I was in LA and he was in New York. I don't know how I sung it first. He was like, yo, do it like this, man, because I'm going to do this and blah, blah, blah. I was like, all right, got you. Boom, boom, boom. I did that, dog. And I'm hearing him. We in the studio. I'm in the booth, and I'm hearing him. So I'm like, technology is crazy. This, and, like, that's why it's so important what you're asking me now and what we're doing right now, because this is a sign of the times. This is one of those things where, like, times change.
No, you're right. I mean, people are ready. I mean, like you said, we are, no matter what the age demographic is, they're ready for something new, because all that turn up, all that daily stuff, it has a place in time, but there's no longevity. So now we're coming back and they're ready for what they recognize and taking the new and kind of just merging everything together.
Merging the two. You're right.
Yeah. Let's talk about just some, you know, like a little bit more on the personal side with you. I know you're really into battle rap.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely. I know you, Shout out to Mook.
Yeah.
T-Rex.
Yeah.
But
what's your take on UK grime and that kind of battle? Are you familiar with all that?
Yeah. You know what? I think everyone, once someone sets the standard or, you know, and they see something that's interesting, like, I think everybody, you know, flocks to it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I think every one of the, you know, URL or Grind Time and all the other ones, I think they're doing an amazing job. You know what I mean? Because that's how rap started. people is looking at rap from a different perspective right now. Yeah. Rap started with battling. You know what I'm saying? Rap, that's how rap started. Like, I'm better than you. Roxanne Shante. Roxanne, you know what I'm saying? Like, Kumo D, LL Cool J. You know what I mean? It goes on and on and on. You know what I mean? But I think those guys that's doing it are embracing what has happened before. And that's what it's about. A lot of times, those great artists that you see, they have embraced what has already happened. You dig what I'm saying? Like me, I've embraced Jackie Wilson. I've embraced James Brown. I've embraced Prince, Michael Jackson. You understand what I'm saying? Fred Astaire. I've embraced so many of those cats because that's what I've incorporated in everything that I do.
But what's dope is that you've been inspired, and but you've taken it into your own and still and still keep it original, because sometimes artists, they're so inspired that they don't realize that they're replicating and making the same.
But that's the difference.
But you've done a good job of like taking like, yo, I love this, and this inspired me to do me,
right?
But with these influences, and I think sometimes artists get lost in the sauce and kind of fail at that. But sometimes, let's be real, you need to go through those moments and put out those records and get criticized, like, yo, you're sounding like so-and-so, and then they realize, okay, then they slowly progress into their own, hopefully. That's always the idea. Yeah. There's always different pathways in getting to there, you know? Do you find inspiration from your battle raps, from the films you watch, and from boxing and all that? And technology, how does that inspire your music?
Well, me, man, you know, let's start it off with my favorite sport, boxing, what I used to do. Mm-hmm. You know, I find that within boxing, it really doesn't matter how good you are. It matters how much you sell yourself. You know what I mean? And with everything else, I've just taken a little piece and a little part of everything that I've been inspired by, whether it be battle rap, singing, boxing, all that stuff. You know what I mean? So I believe that makes you the person that you are. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like a sponge, dude. I absorb. I mean, like, when I'm looking at something, people don't understand what I'm looking at. I always got to go back to my little nephew. You know, he's very critiqueful of every little thing, but I see what it is.
The beautiful ones, different things. You see potential.
I see the potential. So I see way past what's going on right now. And that's a talent. You know what I mean? That's why I always thank DeVonte. You know what I mean? I wasn't Ginuwine the Sung Pony in 90 when he met me. You understand? But he saw that talent. He saw it. He saw the talent in Timbaland. Timbaland wasn't doing boom, 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 boom. He wasn't doing that. You understand? But he
took
saw
time,
that.
Yeah.
He saw that.
Question, Timbaland on his production skills, did he have, because you guys keep talking about writers and artists, did he have someone on the production side that inspired, like, where does he get his drum work and all that? Like, that, what inspires that? Like,
With him, I mean, he would have to tell you, but for me, on the outside looking in, he was a DJ. And I always believe that a DJ that wants to be a producer will probably be the best producer.
That's real.
Because they hear everything. Stuff. They hear it. They hear it.
Whereas if you're just
that's
producing.
That's not even my ears.
Yeah.
But a DJ that's doing what he
everything.
Does, he hears it. And Timbaland was that.
Yeah.
Missy, like I've always, you know, me and Timbaland argue a lot. You know what I mean? And I've always told him, I was like, man, if it wasn't for Missy, I don't know where you would be right now.
Did she keep things like neutral? She was like the peacemaker.
Listen, she wouldn't do nothing unless Timbaland was involved.
Where?
You understand what I'm saying? Because she heard that. She heard it. And, you know, we argue. You know, we family. We do that all the time. But, you know, I've always said, I was like, man, she heard before you. She heard your talent before you heard your talent.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And she still rap, like, she made that record with Pharrell. What's it called? Where They From?
Yes.
What's it called?
Is it Where They From? Love her for that.
And only she can do that. Even in the video, she's still moving.
She got the car commercials. She got all that shit. Yeah, shout out to my girl, Missy. My sister, Missy. Love you, baby. Yeah.
And Also, real quick, let's talk about TGT.
Yo, what's up? Shout out to my boys, Tank and Tyrese, man.
Yeah, but listen, at the time, yo, you got, from our standpoint, that was a legendary super group of our modern time, like in the last couple of years.
Yep.
You know, Tyrese, Tank, Ginuwine coming together, and I know it was a one-off, and I know there was probably, I know it's a lot of persona in one place.
Nah, they're my boys. Yeah. You know what I mean? But
Grammy
you
nominated
understand.
Though.
Yeah, Grammy nominated. You understand? Like you got Tyrese, you got Ginuwine, you got Tank. But listen, when you say Tyrese, Ginuwine, Tank, you got three solo artists that have done it at the top of their level.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And sometimes when you try to merge the three,
it doesn't go so well.
It's a little difficult.
Yeah.
But we are friends. We love each other. And we're trying to work it out.
On a bigger scale, though, I mean, what do you recommend? This goes across the board people that work at a job and people are trying to make a name for themselves.
Yeah.
You know, it's a competitive world. Everyone wants to have a highlight or you know, something that an accomplishment. You know, what did you learn from that situation in terms of when you have so many cooks in the kitchen, you know, how do you finesse the system to where it's you're working as a team rather than against each other?
You know, like working with three bosses, let's first say that. You learn that your way isn't the only way. And that's not speaking only for me, it's speaking for Tyrese, speaking for Tank. And again, to merge the families, because one thing you gotta understand is everyone has a manager, road manager, assistant, people that's got, you know, their back behind them. So when you merge those three families, sometimes there is friction. You understand what I'm saying? And in order for you to, you know, resolve that friction, there's got to be a clearer head. You know what I mean? And sometimes people are not on that level to do that, and you got to give them space. So that's what we've done for each other. I might be that one that I'm talking about. I'm not talking about anybody else but myself. I'm not talking about Tank. I'm not talking about Tyrese. But it takes, three guys to come together and do the right thing and just be on one accord. And right now we're working on that. And I think we will make that happen. But, you know, Tyrese doing his movies, Tyrese doing his thing, Tank doing his thing, I'm doing my thing. So when the time permits, listen, we didn't do TGT until when?
2013, actually. So.
We told y'all about TGT 2007.
Damn, it took a while to get to that point.
So you understand what I'm saying?
It makes perfect sense.
So all I'm saying is I'm always going to tell the truth. I'm always going to tell you about what it actually is, you know what I mean, without getting into detail.
But that's important.
Yeah.
But let's get to, I mean, because musically, regardless of what happened, you guys made some great records. I'm
great
actually playing
records. I think
Sex
TGT,
Ain't Never Felt
listen,
Better.
Listen. I think our CD was one of the best R&B CDs of that year.
Yeah, it was.
I have never listened
Grammy
to myself
nominated.
As
can't
much as
that.
And I've never been nominated for a Grammy.
That's insane.
You understand what I'm saying?
That actually
in 20 years.
That kind of blows my mind, considering like the level of heat.
It blows my mind too, dog. I've always felt like I haven't got my just due.
Does that honestly bother you?
Absolutely. That's why I'm saying it.
Yeah.
I always felt like I haven't gotten my just due. And then sometimes a weaker or lesser individual, it allows you to say, okay, man, listen.
Do you think it's more politics?
Absolutely. We already talked about that.
You know, we won't get into it, but people already know. Mate, yo, you still got it, brother.
Hey, man. Thank
you.
You
still got it. It's insane.
Crazy,
like,
man.
Your voice,
you
haven't really lost a step. It's just about getting in the studio
the right
and making presents. Yes.
The right song with Soulection.
Yes.
Yeah.
You remember when
and
you used to
put the beats on?
Yes, right? It makes sense. Do you remember when you used to be called Tornado?
Absolutely. First of all, I was Infrared.
Infrared?
Infrared.
Yo, name playing is such, like, picking your artist name is so tough,
crazy,
right?
Crazy.
It's like a...
Vital.
Yes, it's so vital.
Vital.
If you weren't doing music, what would you be doing with
boxing.
In your life right now? Boxing? Did you actually train in your...
Absolutely.
Life? You did?
In D.C.
In D.C.?
Yep. The Arboretum in Northeast, Washington, D.C.
Are you aware, you know, because you're from, you know, the DMV, are you connected to anyone musically? Because there's a lot of great music coming out of the DMV right now. Are you in tune?
Yeah, I mean, you know, go-go.
I think on the rise, okay.
You know, go-go, man. Yeah. You know, that's what I mean, I used to be a part of go-go music. And a lot of people, I think that was the mixture, what happened when I came out, because I was a go-go singer and then a go-go band. And because I was so sexual when Pony came out, they said I was a go-go dancer.
Oh, wow.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So there's a lot of history behind that. But no, I never did that. I'm a slim dude.
Yo, do you still get down?
Oh, like, yeah, absolutely, dog.
You still like your choreography?
Know, absolutely. You know what? I just did a movie, Chocolate City Part 2. Mm-hmm. I learned 4 routines mm-hmm. in a day and did them. Not 4 routines, go home, sleep, they come back and do them. Yeah. I learned 4 routines in a day and still did them.
Wow.
So when y'all go check out Chocolate City 2, that's a plug. shout out to Jean-Claude. Yo, when y'all go see that, a lot of those routines I learned that day, so don't judge me.
That's amazing.
You know what I'm saying? But yo, man, it's a great movie, man. I was in Chocolate City 1, and it did great, man. Shout out to all the people that were in it. And you know, I think the second one, though, I'm trying to think of what I'm talking. The second one, I think we got a bigger budget in this. You know, we're in Vegas, we're in a lot of other places, you know what I mean? So I think people are going to appreciate this one even more.
Okay.
You know what I mean? It's going to be great. It's going to be great, man. And I got a bigger part in it.
You got a bigger part.
We got a way bigger part in it. Yeah.
Well, I cannot stress enough, man, like, having you here today, and just for not just the Soulection Culture, for not even just in B2M, but for anyone listening, this is really important. I really hope people, you know, learn something from this.
Yeah.
And this is just like the beginning. I feel like you're on the verge of, like you said, you're more wise now. So you're taking all the wisdom, and you're about to translate that into your new music. So I cannot wait to hear. All right.
I bet you can't. We gotta get in the
stop
studio,
talking
y'all.
Again. The studio.
We gotta get in the studio.
Where's Will I Am? We're about to go find him.
Oh, Will I Am is here. He already said what he gonna do.
We about to make it happen right now.
Yeah,
but yo, man, thank you so much. This is
literally just
the beginning, and it's been amazing to know you for the past couple of years.
I want
to
tell you something, man. I want to thank you for always having my back. Yeah, I mean, you know how far we go back, right?
Yeah.
I want to thank you for always making sure that I'm on point. And, me and my nephew,
and
Monty.
Chris and
just
Monty.
Just want to make sure, Chris, Monty, making sure that I'm on point, making sure that I stay focused and everything, man. Soulection, man. I love y'all, man.
We love you too,
everybody,
man.
Call back. All y'all, dog.
Shout out Esther, Sango.
Yeah, man. All of y'all, man. Yo. Thank y'all so much for supporting me, man. And we're going to win, dog.
We will win.
This is going to be one of those moments where you flashback to when I'm accepting that Grammy. We're like, yo, what's up, Soulection?
I'm going to be right there in my suit. What's up?
It's all good, man. Thank y'all so much. I love y'all, man. I appreciate y'all, man. Y'all keep supporting, and y'all keep doing what y'all doing, man, because y'all doing some big stuff, man.
Yo,
really,
likewise.
Man. I'm so proud of y'all.
Thank you, brother. Yep. We will be back. Let's get some real quick.
Hey. Yes, sir.
All right. Once again, Ginuwine, the legend, we are stepping out. Peace.